Hi, Dave Decaussin here again. I always said that FlashCut is a plug and play. Well, I'm going to demonstrate that this morning. And you'll see that we can have a full control up and running in less than 15 minutes. Here I have the FlashCut's control box. So I bring that over here. This has the amplifiers and everything inside here. So you plug that 110 in. And that's that. You take the USB port plug it into the computer. Now I've already got the software loaded on this computer. Then you get your motors. You got three stepper motors here. And we'll put those over there on our workbench. Use one of my forklifts here to make a horizontal surface there where we can set things. Then here's the plugs for the motors, all tangled up. So here's one plug. We plug this into right into here. Plug the other end into a motor. That'd be here. Do it two more times. Plug and play. Plug and play. Now we're gonna also have a spindle motor. Wait a minute, what's this in here? This seems to be the wrong plug. I don't know. Maybe not. Guess not. And one more plug and play. So that hooks our three motors up. X, Y, and Z. Of course, we aren't making a very pretty cable set up here, but this is just a demonstration. There's our motors. Now, we have an interface board here that has all of the things to run a machine. It's got three air valves, and it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 solid state relays, an output for the coolant pump, and an output for the turret motor. So we plug this in. Okay. Plug it right in there. That's 110. Then we plug this into the upper output. This is the output lines here in the back of the machine. All right, that takes care of that. Now we've got a coolant pump, and it's this here. So we plug the coolant pump into its appropriate plug here. I believe it's this one here. Okay, there's the coolant pump. Then the spindle motor. You get a spindle motor with a vector drive hooked up to it. And this vector drive runs a three-phase motor off 110 volts, which is pretty nice. It's a little unit made by Delta. So plug that in. Everything takes 110. All right, then that's on. So this here plug is the DAC output. Shoot, the wire broke. Dang it. I'll have to fix that somehow. The DAC, this is the encoder DAC. This is a DAC output. Okay, and then this cord here plugs in to here. All right, so. Okay, so we got everything here to make a CNC machine, and I don't think we have 5 minutes in here yet. We got the interface for the valves and the turning on the various functions for the tool changer. We got a centralized vector drive here. a three-phase, 1.5 horsepower motor here, three axes, X, Y, and Z, and a coolant pump. So I've already loaded the software. That's a no-brainer. But what I'm going to do now is we're going to touch jog. Oh, this is not a touch screen. My other ones are touch screens. Jog. Z. Z.
What is that?
Amazing, isn't it? X. Y. That's fast. Then we go to aux here, and we turn on the coolant pump. You hear the coolant pump come on, it's right here. There's the coolant pump.
Yeah, look at the pump.
Yeah. And then we go to the spindle on, and the spindle comes on. 500 RPM. We can take it up to 1,000, but it's lovely.
Where are you going there?
There's 1,000 RPM. You can go all the way up to 3,000. If I slow it down too fast, this thing's liable to roll off onto the floor. But that's it. You got a full CNC setup. Plug and play, like I always say. What'd that take? About 7 or 8 minutes? Anyways, that's it. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.